you saw the box. Honestly, I have no idea. So this is something I've never done. I've never spoken about this at all. So it took me a while to grasp it, to understand it, okay? And then try to reflect back on my working life, in my own self, at this present moment. Because Sunita, when she prepared this slide, she commented, you know, Venga, we have not branded ourselves very well in terms of what's the statement you make? And say it loudly. Don't be angry.
No, I felt that we did not brand ourselves well enough.
Come here.
Because I had to prepare the slides, so I went to read articles on branding.
Come near me, don't worry. I'm old.
So I had to read articles on branding. So in many organizations have, so I went into many organizations, beautifully done, so well, very, very impressive. You immediately, you know exactly what people are good at. So if you know your needs, then you can find people much faster. So we as service providers, we have to brand ourselves well. We don't know, nobody knows us. And especially now, with social media and its heights, I think we must. Not just company, personally as well. So I felt we cannot do that.
She's entitled to opinion. But, okay. I can say this, okay? Unconsciously, we have done exactly that. In the early phase, when we had some 50 people working here on the trading business alone, we have unconsciously, we went around to see a lot of people. Otherwise, we wouldn't have sold the idea of the system to telecoms or Cellcom, the big companies that used us, you know, Tractor, all sorts of people. We sold every year without fail something like about 2,000 systems. You know. Some of them at that time, there was a hype about time management, and I came in the right time. We didn't. But then we pursued this to go on. Then, you know, the whole thing flattened out. So as I was reading through and trying to look at it, I said, actually, every single person unconsciously actually tried to brand himself or herself. Let me start off with a simple thing. Okay. Why do you wear a scarf?
That's my brand.
You see? You wore the scarf because there was must be a reason. You may have done it unconsciously, but you are branding yourself in that way.
I want to match my scarf in my attire.
You see, you may do it for yourself, or you may not do it. Eh?
Yeah.
I've seen you before, haven't I?
No, it's the first time I've seen you.
Who persuaded you to come here? Sundres. Okay. You're from where?
Previously from AstraZeneca.
Sorry?
Previously from AstraZeneca. Uh-huh. Now that I'm just looking for a job now.
You're looking for a job?
Yeah.
How come? How come?
We have actually closed the department and then transferred to medical and they require us to travel and I'm not so interested. That's the job.
What made you come here?
So that I
friend of yours.
So that I can brand myself well for my new job.
Your friend?
Yeah.
Your friend? You know that I built that company, huh?
Yes, I.
Okay. See, like for instance, in a climate like this,
yeah.
Why you wear this? You call that a stocking or socks?
Stockings.
Huh? Is that a stocking? Sorry. Why do we wear this in a warm climate like that? Why?
Actually, I
think
it's warm.
You see, we have done this unconsciously.
But maybe this question is very wearing is proper. If you wear a dress, you should wear stockings. That's how they teach you.
Well, that's what...
You don't expose your legs. You must wear stockings proper and covered shoes.
Okay. See, again, the seller of these things, brand it and make you brand yourself. See, so you also, I'm not saying that you shouldn't be doing it, I'm saying that, hey, you actually brand yourself in a lot of ways. Many of us do it unconsciously. Like, as an example, I always wear a tie. Okay? It's only in the last 2 years now I stopped wearing a tie. Not because I think I'm wearing, nobody comes here with a tie, so I say, hell, it's so high, so I won't wear a tie. But if I could see a customer as an example, I always wear a tie.
By the way, I was coming to a tie, no way. I was coming to a tie, that's it.
Those days, yes. Then you became a bad boy. So, branding is like this. I mean, first, take the simple aspect, okay? It is necessary for us to brand ourselves. This does not mean that you are going all out to sell yourself. No, it's not that. You want to show people, or at least attract people who are equally willing to talk to you, or an outsider do not feel apprehensive. Can I not? And you're afraid. So, in a way, gives you that people. Some people have this tremendous ability to be pleasant, and people do not. Are not afraid to approach you. So in a way, you have branded yourself in that aspect. A lot of this, it is not a hyper part of the moment, hype meaning to brand a product. Okay. I have been involved in industries previously now, where we need to brand our company. And one of the things that we did was, in branding the word ASTI, we worked out the logo type, the color, the size, and a whole lot of things we did. We made a book, a volume like that, taken. You know, that's what we're talking about. And these are in the 1960s. So, and when we launched a product, we also looked at the name, how should it appear, and all sorts of things we did. Like branding it for the, in this case, consumers. Meaning the doctors are doing this product. So I've been through that, okay. But I went back today, a few days ago, saying, from the very beginning, have I ever thought about this branding myself, or branding anything? Okay. Sometimes we do it very unconsciously. We want others to perceive us. Hey, welcome back. 20 years already, huh?
20
over
years.
20 over years, huh? Are you still using the meal planner?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Is he still a user?
Yes.
Very good. Okay.
Yes.
That's to you. Okay. So, ask me something. Is it possible that we become a little more conscious about what we do to become, say, you have a brand that people trust. See, I am of the opinion, especially people selling a product or a service, or you want to be a salesperson, whatever that is, the element of trust between you and the customer today is at a very low level. Because everybody wants to make a quick buck, say a quick nice thing, get the sales and run away. It's always a one-time sales. It's never continuous, ongoing sales. I mean, you see the same customer again and again and again. And then I always quoted a name to her. She probably heard the name, but never even read about it. It's called Joe Gerard. Remember, I always mentioned that. You remember that Joe Gerard? Okay. actually, I never thought about this branding until she told me. There is a salesman that she met who sold her the current car that she's driving on the. And this Joe Gerard started being a salesperson in the 1950s. He sold over 1 million cars a year. Okay? And he sold to the same location. He did not travel intercity. Within the same location that he did it, he sold. Every single person bought a car from him. And he always started by selling to one person first. And his idea of a sales is, once I sell you a car, it is my responsibility to look after your car. So he had a knack of calling you back every week to find out the car's all right, that it, does it need fixing, does it need anything to be done. When she told me that your car needed to change a tire, but all cars need to change their tire in 2 years, you can use that. Tire of a car only for 2 years. Are you aware of that?
6 years.
Huh?
6 years.
Huh? Who's your
mechanic? He never wanted to change.
You see, after 2 years, the tire is not valid anymore. You meet in an accident, it exploded, insurance will kick you off. It's in the insurance policy. Every 2 years, you must change that. This is what Joe Gerard did. From a one person sale, he sold to every single person in the family, including great grandchildren. And the reason why they bought from him was because of the fact that he was truly a person who looked after your interests. That was his premise. And because of that, in the club, everywhere else, if there was a car they needed, they went to Joe. And Joe would fix it. And like that, it spread completely. Now, I was surprised to learn there is such a salesperson working for Honda.
There is.
And that person has now sold a car to Sundas. Okay? I met a salesman like that in Malaysia. And his name was Sunny. He was the first person, I don't know whether you were on at that time, when he sold me the Toshiba computer. Were you there at that time?
Toshiba computer.
Not the CK. CK's salesman. The one you know who?
I know it's Jason.
Jason. But Jason was put on to me by Sunny. And because of Sunny, who took the trouble, all he did was a simple thing. I bought the first time. I bought a computer called Wang. It was about a 20-ton weight with a printer and I suffered carrying it. And I didn't work on it. Somebody else used it. Okay. Now, when he explained to me about how computers can store quite a lot of information, all that, remember we are talking about a 10 megabyte hard disk at that time. Okay? And a 1.25 RAM. That's the stage that I'm talking about here. At that point in time, when he took the trouble to travel all the way to Port Dickson, where I was, I didn't know how to start the computer because of the pen. All I needed to do was to look for a small little hole and push it with a pencil to keep it restart again. I didn't know that. It was on a Saturday afternoon. And he drove all the way from Kuala Lumpur, all the way to Port Dickson, and came and poked him. They went over again. That impressed me. And ever since that time, until lately, until I went to this particular surface, I always used Toshiba. And because of me, our whole company in Thailand, where we have about, I don't know, 700-800 computers, all Toshiba. Okay, like that, wherever I go to, I promoted Toshiba. Is that a Toshiba? Okay, it's good. So like that, there are some people you meet, they brand themselves as someone who cares for you and someone who can, you can rely on. But that to me is a simple way of looking at branding yourself. Somebody who can be reliable. He can be medium form, but somebody who's reliable can also be that he's branding himself to become a very reliable person to support you. Okay? Now, we all know this one. And the fact is that because you have to spend time and effort, the sales people do not have time and effort. This is true. And sometimes salesmen or salespeople are pushed away. Because of this fast, quick thing, I want it now, and then I want it quickly. Huh? So that's okay. So yes, branding may have happened, but in a very unconscious way. So let's look at this little picture, okay? Are each one of them trying to brand themselves? Are they one? They are. But their branding is in their smile, their face. It's not the cloth or the dress they use. That also can also mean the way, oh, she dressed very nicely all the time. Very matching colors and so on and so on. Okay? Yes. But also, somebody outside. Okay, also, this is another way. You see this particular thing, see this? This is also a branding now. Did you know that? Actors, some specific actors, you look at that very carefully, yeah? They have this kind of teeth, a hollow in between.
Madonna is got that.
Okay. I'm talking about actors. Madonna is an actor.
She's a
singer. Okay. I'm saying this. Eh? This is also one of this is also a branding. You see this? This. Yeah? Branding. How they show it. Okay. This is also a branding. Yeah. Oh, this is another branding. This is how they look. If you look at CNN, you will see this. Every single one that comes up, okay, is branding themselves. Whether it is Armand Folk or the South African girls that are reading the news, they are branding themselves. You understand? So everyone does it. Even in the male side, they also brand themselves. That's one way of looking. Again, when you attend a conference or you go to a seminar and you see some people always there sitting in front, picking up your hand and asking questions. Then you ask yourself, why is it that these people are in front and always asking questions? Why? Not because they want to show what they know, but they're also branding somebody who open and ask a question. And this is how they're branding themselves.
Yeah.
And people pay attention to these people. Do you understand what I'm saying? Usually. But maybe this is a bit alien to us, you know, in Asian society, where we are told that you should be seen and not heard. And this is the way we are brought up, you know. I am fortunate, and you are all unfortunate, in the sense that you were brought up by your parents, or mother or father, or somebody brought you up and told you what to do, what not to do. I was never brought up by anybody else, so I am what I am. Many people are taught in their home how to behave. That conditioning already starts at home. Because the mother and father or the relatives are teaching the children what they did as a child, which is already another 30, 40 years old. And then 30, 40 years old comes to now. And now as a child grows up, with the amount of technology around and the exposure and all that, the child will definitely have difficulty growing up in a developing world. This is a problem. Like if I take some of us here and then put you in a Western society and ask you to live there for 6 months, many of us may not survive that. Unless you are able to adapt. And even adaptation, that's why you find that the group is said that as a Malaysian, and then you will always group together the same old people you meet. You will never mix with the others. You want to be on your own. In a little cocoon. Okay? We don't expose, we are not exposed to that. Okay? That unfortunately did not happen to me at a very young age. I was on my own most of the time. So this is something that you must understand. Okay? So to make this, to understand this, okay? this is also a fact, okay? And this you see that many a time, okay? You see, 3% of the human population make things happen, 17% watch things happen, and then you have 80% wonder what happened. Now, the majority of people in our society are sitting here. We are here. Now, we can't move from here to there. We can't. But the opportunity is presenting itself now, the new government is presenting itself now. There's a chance for you to actually do what you can, what you cannot do. There's a possibility. I see this effect. I stand to be corrected 4 years from now, or 5 years from now, but I see the path towards better energy. It's not going to overturn tomorrow morning, but surely things are happening. So the opportunity is for us to see that. How do you see that? Okay, is to go from here to become better. But staying here will not be very good. This is not the middle class. Okay? In fact, the middle class may also belong to here. But these are the people like yourself, Chandrika. You watch this. But you need to take that one step. That one step will make the difference. That's what I told you just now. Okay. Like that, you need to find out. Okay. Again, one thing that we talk about very loosely is our values. If you are used to telling what you consider as a white lie, that's your value. Or if you don't want to tell the truth as it is, but when you tell your version of the truth, you blend it to make it palatable, then that's your value. At the same time, how do you deliver a message without being vulgar or without being annoying or very roughly presented? There are many ways to do it. So your skill in communication becomes important also. So all that plays a role. Now, this is a statistic that is worldwide. This is a worldwide statistic that shows those who make things happen are people who are willing to take risk, meaning that they are willing to try something new, that which has never been done before. This is not our culture. It is not a Malaysian culture. We like to do what others have done, and we try to modify that a little bit, thinking we're improving a little bit. Okay, that's why I can never understand, as an example, why you have to pay 18 ringgit for a cup of coffee from Starbucks. I could never understand. Coffee bean is coffee bean. But they branded it as a social place to be. They're not selling coffee. They're selling a place for you to meet. That's the message. It became a worldwide trend. You understand? You understand what I'm saying? But I'm not selling coffee. I am selling a product which is got to do with change of behavior. Self-behavior need to change. And this is a very difficult product to sell. It's a very, very difficult product to sell. You're not selling pills or medicine. It's easy to sell. You're selling a behavior change. And that behavior change can happen between here and here. Will never happen here. But those people who come and attend for the last 32 years are people from here. That's why when they told me, let's go to Park, I said, I want people now to come here. take the trouble, you want to change, you want to help yourself come here, then you better find a way to come here. What should I do with you? You have done it for 22 years anyway. Okay? This is free. Why not? So, you see what I'm saying? I'm saying that these people, they spend a lot of time and effort to brand it, but they also have failed tremendously, even at the expense of their own health, their own family life and all that. Steve Jobs is a good example of that, who regretted before his death that all the money in the world cannot give him a day with his daughter, the first daughter which he never cared for. He wrote it in a book before he died. Like that. So I'm saying, hey, there are certain values that you all have. You need to find the values. In examining the values, you must then relate that value to the job that you are doing. That is, this is who I am. This is the job I'm doing. Am I just doing a job? Or is my value matching with the job? And the next thing is, if I work in an organization, can I stand among the crowd and be seen? In other words, am I interacting? This is not a show off, you know. Whatever assignment given to you, are you able to deliver? Are you able to deliver quality? Not because you want to be better than them, but in fact, you are willing to fight with others to make it even better. You are willing to express your opinion, although that opinion that you're expressing may not be in depth. This is again not a very much an Asian, but it's coming up now. But in Malaysia, we don't express our even if we want to express it, we will express it after that to somebody else, a third party, you know. So when I feel that they should have not done that, you know, instead of directly addressing it in a group. That's the brand that you need to develop. You're afraid that somebody at the top may think otherwise about you. Therefore, you won't express your opinion. Does that make sense? Does that make sense? It does. Does it make sense? You're new here, are you? Yes. Where are you from? Rao, okay. Where is he?
He's in India. Okay.
He's gone to JB. Good. He's a user of ours, right? Okay, very good. Did you come all the way from you borrowed to him? He's got an office in Puchong also. Is that right? So you can see that it requires you to exert yourself. Brand, it doesn't mean how you dress, but more importantly is the way you express yourself. That's why I said just now to you, Pakyan, that sometimes you need to think of the depth and the width of the statement you're going to make. Whether in fact, people, if I say this, what will the reaction be? But doesn't mean that you should not express it, but you should express it in a different way altogether. So that again is branding in that way. So you can see as a person, this is an example of it. Okay? See, if you take a person like this, okay? Of course, this is what you call image. This is looking in the mirror, huh? Exactly. But behind this is also another person, isn't it? Yes or no? Okay? Unless this and this becomes one, then, only then, the branding of yourself becomes easier. If you try to show, a couple of weeks ago, I went to see someone, and we were talking, and I can see that person, very artificial in the way talking about in that conversation, I noticed that there is a certain amount of a thin wall, you know. They're not prepared to let them out. You remember one of the person that you did the PIP, person inside profile, remember? That person, you told the person, you put in a facade all the time, and it's difficult to hold that facade for a long time. And the person told you yes, okay? And then we discussed it, we talked about it. A lot of people put a facade. They don't want to show who that person is, but outside everything. Those kind of people have a problem. That's why I told you what I told you just now. You need to take that person, match it together. These are your thoughts, no, this is not person, these are your thoughts, your experience, your whatever. You have to bring it open and realize that this is what it is. Okay? Now, every time I talk to you, you have attended almost all the sessions I've been holding for the last 32 years. Tell me this again. At any one more point in time, do you feel that I'm putting it on and not being sincere what I'm saying? Have you ever felt that way?
To talk about experience.
Okay. I always have some experience to match with what I'm saying. But more importantly, I have a conflict in this sense that I believe if I cannot do it myself, I will not tell somebody else to do it. Okay? When I push, like I push people to do things, because I think time has come, like this, okay, you have grown up to that level. From now on, you have to go on your own, and you cannot expect me to hold your hand. So like this afternoon, Sundas and I had a little discussion. I said, oh, I hope you respond, we'll get that done. So I believe that she should develop her own. And unless I do that, she will never do it. She will rely on somebody else, and somebody else will rely on somebody else. And that won't happen. Okay? Have you ever seen how Celine is using the bee planner now? Have you ever observed it? If now I sent her to some place and sent her to teach people how to use the system. Is that a yes? Have you seen Sunita, how she's using the system now? Look at Sundar also. Although she used it, but now she's slowly in a different, in a way. This is when you match this and this, when this two gets together, then it becomes easier for you to handle yourself. If you keep a separate, how I appear to somebody else, what will be somebody else think about me and all that, that's going to be a problem. So let's take this as a base, okay? And then speak about this branding data. First and foremost, understand this, okay? As I stated here, okay, now, see, every single person, irregardless of who you are, when you work for somebody, you want to do your best. And you want to give your best input. Nobody goes to work, join a company, work for somebody for the sake of a few dollars. No? They actually want the dollar, but they are willing to put their best to contribute to that organization. This is a fact. There's no denial. Whether you belong to the 3%, the 17%, or the 80%, you want to do this. And then this is the key. See the last word, skill. That is already you have inherent inside you. But the problem is those skills that you have at the time of going to workplace were always something that you picked up from your parents, your brother, your sister, your uncle, your auntie, something like that, may not be applicable in the new environment. Because you're going to work with people who are different. So how do you adapt it into that situation? That adaptation becomes an issue. And that's why you want to tear yourself off and you're not doing that. My view has always been like that. Why not take the challenge and try it? Huh? Like if you do not like to travel. So what's wrong with that? What is wrong? I mean, a woman can travel very freely in this country. But why not? You understand? All these are adaptation. You want to live the way you lived before, like your parents are. Then you belong to the himself. But if you want to get on in life, you need to venture into it. So that's a risk you must take. You can't live in your comfort zone. Because you must outshine. Because everybody is competing for the same thing, whether you like it or not. Everybody wants to.
If you're comfortable with where you are, why you need to change? You're comfortable.
Well, back here to answer your question, yes, you belong to the 80% of the people. It's okay. Stay there. Don't grumble. Don't complain. If I get one negative word out of you, you're not satisfied. Thank you. Then you want to be dissatisfied, but at the same time, you don't want to look at yourself. You cannot change. So change management, changing yourself, takes a lot of guts to get it done. And that's not easy. I wish it was easy. I honestly wish it was easy. It's not. It's a very difficult thing to do. Why? Because we have all the time lived in a comfortable zone. We live at home, it's comfortable. We live with our parents, it's comfortable. We dare not leave the parents, or we want to live very close by, nearby, all that happens. But then, things are changing. Things are changing and rapidly moving on. So you've got to fit into that. And that's where the problem is. A lot of us are not prepared to do that. When we are not prepared to do that, what happens then is that we stay where we are. And then time has moved on, and other people have got ahead of us. Then we become jealous. Okay? There is no such thing as you don't have to compete, you will get there. It can never happen. If there was 61 years of our rule, even that has changed. You understand? Even after 61 years, we have changed government. So you can see it will happen whether you like it or not. And because it's going to happen, we, if you use this as a scale, okay? See, because everybody has the same frame of mind, meaning that, hey, I have this talent, but is this talent relevant to what people are doing now? I meet people, young people, you know? Okay? When I say young, say about 50 years old, who are not even using emails. There are people like that. Okay. Now, these people have a problem. But they are very comfortable using WhatsApp. But not email. They cannot differentiate between email and WhatsApp. You understand? They must change because it requires you to adapt to the new situation. So, having said that, what then, if this is the case where everybody wants to do something to themselves and become something, what happens? Why is it not happening? Why are they missing out on opportunity? And that has been put in the red, yeah? Because you don't intentionally brand yourself at what you can deliver. You don't. Okay, Celine is a good example. She will do the work you tell her to do, but she will not offend anyone. But I need her to offend people to get things done. Okay, she has a brand. Okay, but nowadays she's a little stressed out because I'm making her stress out because I want her to demand a lot of things from her, which requires her to get it done. So like that, you see this one. You see, because unless, when you work with people, anywhere you work, unless you're willing to show your talent, no one will ever, ever give you, a job, or willing to give you a new assignment, unless you are willing to show that you are willing to take risk. You understand? You understand? I had an incident with one person where I recommended to the company that this person took a decision without consulting, and this has caused a problem with the company. Therefore, in giving her the bonus, you need to emphasize that, and because of that, you must deduct a certain amount out. So this person will learn. The end result was like that, okay? Yes, accepted, no issue at all. But then after that, everything this person wanted to do, she made sure a superior approved it. Okay? So we have come to a situation that person doesn't want to take a risk. Okay? Because of that punishment. But that means that person is actually not mature enough. So I told the person what to do with her. Okay? To sit down and explain to her. That was a punishment for a mistake that you made. A mistake that should have not happened. How could you have avoided that? If you were not sure, you could have checked with me. I'm your superior. We could take the decision together. Right? But every time you come now to get my okay, doesn't mean responsibility is not with you. You understand what I'm saying, man? So that's another thing. So most people sit there because why? They are never ever seen in a crowd. So therefore, although you work very hard, but nobody is seeing you because you have no way to show your personality or show your brand. Okay? And that requires a certain amount of skill in the way you communicate, in the way you make things happen. That's what I'm saying, okay? I don't know why this is a kind of thing. Okay, I don't expect you to be the American, every American on show, okay? I don't mean that. I mean, there is a way in which you can present yourself well. And especially in Malaysia, we now have the opportunity. Actually, they're calling New Malaysia. You know that? It's a common word I'm using. It's a New Malaysia. Okay? There's an area for you, and you can see that it can work. So, what do you need to do? What do you need to do? First, I think it's like that. The thing that is in my mind, at least, and you can see that, everywhere you go to, there is a tremendous amount of competitiveness. Yes? Yes or no? Your job can be replaced tomorrow by somebody else. Is that a yes? Can be, right? Okay? Alright. Now, we know for a fact, okay, even this morning I was talking to somebody who says, I want somebody to employ somebody who's very good in English. Do work on her own, it's a female, right? Somebody who can take care of us. Right? I said to that person, how much are you willing to pay? But the next sentence that came out, we can't afford it. Then I said, do it yourself. Because you want somebody in English, okay? Somebody who can type, put it together and take care of secretarial work. So there's a certain amount of fee that comes to that. Okay? And those who can do English very well are people above the age of 40 and already earning an income, maybe 4,000 or 5,000 a month, something like that. Then I'm going to throw the job away and for 2,000 or 3,000 to get it. Yeah? You understand? So it also has that. Okay? So here you can see it. That because it's very competitive, whatever traditional way of doing this now, the one-notch promotion, you know, when I first joined one company a long time ago, the increment was $15 a year. $15 a year. For a short period, you know, this before I went up to join the pharmaceutical company, it's $15 a year. I said, my God, it'll take me 100 years. Forget that, okay. But hey, but you know what? All that has changed completely. So yes, isn't it? So from this, we need to have this. I'm not sure what I can do before somebody can promote me. Is that right or wrong? Is that right or wrong? How do you show that? How do you show that you are the best employee? How do you show that? Or you want to remain a mediocre? How do you show that? Your performance. Hold it now.
Performance.
Okay, job performance, yes. See, some people term it as depending on performance, and that could be quickly interpreted as selling. It's not that, it's the overall performance in what you do. That are you better than the next person beside you? No need to show off. But somebody must recognize that you have the ability to do this and do that. And by that you can grow. That's what I'm saying. You can see that thing. So this is what they call personal branding. The branding of an individual themselves. Not wearing a t-shirt and say, I am this. No? That's not branding of the way you dress. But rather in your performance. Okay. I met two young people. A couple of days ago, and both of them were telling me that, you know, this is a big multinational company they're working for. Both are young. Both are engineers in their own right. And they both, one in the field of electrical, something to do with electricity, another one involved in physics. Physics as in it's another very technical field now. But you can see that between the two, they're both young, they are in a hurry to go above this because they see the dollar cents as something that can take them there very quickly. I see differently. They have been assigned new job to do, new things to do, taken over a very huge project now. Which is an amount which cannot even mention. This lighting is about $1 trillion project. Okay, within the $1 trillion, he has got a major part to play, and he's very young. But he has people, also engineers, who not report to him, but can be used to do the project. In which those people. You tell me what to do, I do. I won't go beyond that. So every time, if I have to tell you every step of the way, I'm also doing myself. You understand? Which is what they want. So they think that you are the boss of life. You earn more than me, you are. So you do not. See the attitude. So I advise them. It's good for you. You know what? Then you learn how to do it. Then you know what? You go one step further. Okay? One day, these people will talk to you. But you've got to go on. You've got to work day and night to get there. But you must take the risk. I told him another way to do it. Is get approval from your boss to train these people. Actually run a formalized training. When you're doing a project, certain things you can teach people. Even though you have not done it, but experience and what have you can put together and you can make it happen. But, which takes a lot of effort, this is also planning. So, that's what I'm saying. Eh? So, let's go further. Okay? See, this is an important question. Okay? Do you ever consider that branding is important? Or you can say, who cares what other people think? You can do that too. If you do that, then you cannot grumble with jealousy and you know, and I see people, oh, you are living. Huh? Yes? Yes, Anna. I mean, let me put it this way, Anna. One of the reasons why our country, in a lot of ways, has been tempered and spoiled. They don't have that urge to actually go out and do better. That stage has come now. Unless you push yourself, I am saying that in all honesty, I'm saying that if any person in Malaysia does not do well, it is his own doing, his or her own doing. It's not because of the government. If they are foolish, you want free handout. And that won't happen. Okay? Whether there's no race in this, okay? There's no race. Those people who have not progressed in the last 61 years, they are to be blamed themselves. You could have done it well. From now on, it's going to be tough. It's going to be really tough. So they're looking for people, okay? And this is a fact, because our measurement, the way we measure our people in terms of their performance, is still very, very poor. Temperature, you know this, okay? Acceptable, satisfactory.
But we're slowly moving to objectively quantifying the performance.
Okay.
We are moving towards that.
Tell me how.
Because like we have got, we actually calculate how many number of, like, because I come from hospital, right? So how many number of patients or examination is supposed to do. We have a KPI. And whether that person, we actually have a system to measure.
Are you very good? And that's measured weekly, monthly, or?
We have weekly roster, and based on that number of patients, X number of patients, and monthly, and then subsequently,
very good. Is it cumulative number?
Cumulative.
So now you have come to measuring objectively. Now, is the performance of that individual, does he know that when he puts the chart in that he's being measured, does he know that?
We have this dashboard thing that he can monitor.
Okay, himself?
Yes.
Very good.
He monitor and the supervisor will remind him you are lacking.
Okay. And what kind of training is given to the supervisor for him or her to constantly monitor that?
We have, of course, at this point of time, there's still work in progress.
Okay,
fine. What this person, I really appreciate that the person who actually went out of the way to find some method actually.
Very good.
Develop himself and then share with us, and now it's going to a different level.
Very good. That's very good. And that's one center, or it's a whole unit doing it.
There's one pilot done in another department, but we have kind of taken the model, but we have improvised the model.
Very good. Okay.
Going to go to a different level.
Okay. So you see, already you're starting a brand within yours, and then that could be shared out. That's what I'm saying. I say, see, you need to ask yourself this question: do I need to expose myself of things that I know, others may not know? Should I expose myself and telling people that there's something I read about or heard somebody talk about it? Is it okay? Actually, you're sharing. This is not a show off. You see, that's the way to progress. You can't wait for people to tell you how this or that is to be done. You need to actually come out and show people what you can. You have to show. Then only people recognize you. Okay, good. Maybe I give you something new to try. See, that's the key. See, again, if you read this case, you see, this self-branding, maybe in Malaysian context, or people in Malaysia, may find this not a good word to use. But you must think like this, unless you brand yourself, nobody will recognize you. I mean, if you're married, you know, you better get it straight, but that because you're married to someone, Does it mean you stay married for a long time? You need to brand one another. You have got to really try to communicate to otherwise there will be separation. There will come a point in which you're not able to. Okay, so that's also party branding at an individual level. But this particular thing which interests me most is the fact that I look at the crowd, all of you, you work with somebody, or you will be working with somebody. You need to tell people what you are good at. You don't tell, I wouldn't know. You can take the attitude, you employed me, right? So it's for you to pick up what I'm good at. You can have that attitude, sure. But because you work in a small organization of 5-6 people, it's okay. But when you're working 50 people or 100 people, cannot. You have to be a person to show off what you can do.
But I must share that over the years that I do see people who really come out and share their ideas, their thoughts, their knowledge, their skills, right? These are the people who actually been sought after.
Yes.
Even
you are speaking about government service,
yeah,
as in the university. If that's happened in university, that's good. So there is a tremendous opportunity. But I still feel that we are not there yet. I feel that way, whether it's a private sector or otherwise.
But I think we can't blame government or private. It's the individual themselves that want to make that changes.
And provided they're exposed.
Yes.
See, in your case, you have used a lot of your own resources to develop your own self. Okay? And because you went up and it's not the seminars you went to, but of course meeting people, you learn a few things and you're willing to make that happen in your life. And that progressively has given you that frontage, meaning expressing, willing to tell people what you need. But not everybody has that type of risk they take. They rather live in their own little...
That's my challenge right now, to develop more people to go out and share. Slowly, getting those people to come out from their cocoon.
But to these people, if you want them to become you, then you must set that example.
Yeah.
Meaning, not only at both levels, but as I told you, just don't remember. That's the key. See, we are all have one problem. And the problem is our thought controls us. And if you do not know the difference between thoughts and intelligence, then no one can help you. Because right now, all what you know is your thoughts. These thoughts are the past. That is not intelligence. Intelligence is not coming out. Thoughts are coming out, and in a lot of ways, suppressing your intelligence. Because intelligence requires something else. And unless you get a control of that, it will be always whatever you have received up to now from your, from whatever you have seen, heard, smell, touch, your senses. That's what you know. What you don't know is your intelligence. And your intelligence has been misused for other purposes. So, that's why you see here, it is required. Okay? See, because you live in today's world, okay, you have a lot of talent. Yes, but you're unable to do that or show it. Unless you start to think about, hey, how can I make that happen? You can't read a book and make it happen. You need to test that within your workplace. You need to try it out. Okay? And progress, okay? So, taking that as a cue, you go one step further, okay? Is personal branding an important part of our life? I think, yes, it is. And you know what?